everyone. It's very exciting, as always, whenever Sid and I meet. A quick introduction. Sid is Vice President for Technology and Development for Dish Network. And Sid, you and I have had a long association for more than 2 years now.
Yes, we have.
And it's very, very humbling to have another connect with you. Just wondering, 18 to 24 months long journey. And when we started and here we are now, we just went live. What do you think from where you started up, where we are now, your objectives towards your own customers, your end customers, how's that unfolding for you?
Thanks, Jatin. By the way, great to be here again. Nice to see you again, as usual. Yeah, journey has been fun. I think the way I describe it is that there's nowhere else I would rather be right now instead of here. But we have come along a long way. There's been a lot of work done. We have done something unique. We proved Open RAN. We did a complete deployment on AWS Core, the first of its kind in the world. So amazing journey. Coming back to the objective, I think if I take a macro view, the way I say is that our objective is to connect people and things and to change the way the world communicates. So that's a macroscopic view. But now, if you drill down, 5G is just the first of milestone, I would say, first milestone for us to achieve. So after that, we'll have a probably 6G and something beyond that. We're in the connectivity business. So this is a big step forward for us. I know we're a new operator. We have done something amazing, changed the history here, changed the landscape. But again, looking forward to see how we change the communication landscape in the future.
That's very interesting. And you know, there's a whole lot of buzz. I mean, you've been a disruptor and a new kid on the block, as they say it, but more so a disruptor out there. And there was a lot of talk about new value creation and B2B value creation. How do you see that coming along?
It's good, actually. So the first step we have to do to create a value is to make sure we have a network, more precisely the network architecture that meets the customer demand, that can meet the customer demand as to how they feel it, in the sense that I cannot have one size fits all. So you need to have a programmable network. That's very important. And what we have done in so many months is that we have emphasized the need to be a cloud native architecture so that you have a scalable modular system that can be deployed on any cloud, any infrastructure, so that you can meet the customer demands and you can program your network to satisfy their SLAs and requirements, have intelligence into the network. Instead of saying that I have this giant network, why don't I subscribe millions of customers to one network? So it's like millions to many. We have an opposite view of many to many, like many customers to many networks. So it's coming along good. I think we have made progress. We have done quite a bit deployment, but next is we take it to the next level of automation.
That's right. And how do you see Nokia playing a role in the last 2 years for you?
Simplest term, I would say Nokia has been fabulous in the sense that we are a startup company, no doubt about that. We were coming up, we had little workforce. So when we started working with Nokia, there are two things that were very important for us. One is Nokia needs to believe in the vision that we are, because we want to be disruptor and we wanted someone to take risk along with us because we were going into what I call uncharted territory. So I'm glad Nokia took the journey with us. I'm sure you enjoyed that one too. But now at the same time, we also need advice, right? As you build a new network, there are some things which you don't know. Nokia being a veteran, deployed hundreds of networks globally. We have leveraged Nokia's expertise over a period of time. They can tell us, hey, you may want to avoid this because these are the problems you see in the future. It's not a scalable solution. This is something operationally not right way to do. So that's experience we got from Nokia, which has been tremendously helpful. But again, as I said, this is just the beginning. I'm just amazed to see where we go next from here.
No, you're right. And actually, I must say that, you know, if I look at this whole journey, I mean, Dish has been a pioneer in building a truly disintegrated, disruptive hybrid cloud, as you called it this morning as well. And just wondering, you know, in that hybrid cloud journey of yours, and there is a whole lot of talk about use of public cloud networks and AWS, and any reflections on that, and how did that come along in a real-time communications network?
It was not simple, right? I'll be completely honest. When we first started journey of AWS, there were like a thousand reasons or naysayers who were telling us that why it cannot be done. But I remember also a discussion that, hey, we have decided to do public cloud, AWS in particular, and how can Nokia get through it? And I'm glad that we did that, and Nokia came through. We have deployed completely. In fact, let me be very more specific. We are deployed in 3 out of 4 public regions in AWS. We are deployed in multiple availability zones and almost all the local zones. That means we are deployed with Nokia applications across AWS around the country. In fact, that we have done, accomplished, no problem there. But now what we're looking for is that what's next? We have done one public cloud, but how do we take it to the next public cloud? How do we be true multi-cloud, true hybrid multi-cloud? I think that's the journey we're going to take next and see how it goes.
Yeah, that's fantastic. And any words about the word of automation? I know you touched on the topic of automation. that's the big thing.
Yeah. I think automation is a journey, right? You know this more than me, but it's an evolution. Every small step we make on automation, it's tremendous, whether it's an operational or it's a functional. But the way I see is that, and probably it's a challenge I should throw to you right now, is that together with Nokia, I see a vision where we are, and I'll make it up right now, it's a cloud-based telco network driven by AI. A completely autonomous network which is able to learn, heal, and scale with minimal human intervention. So how about we make that happen?
No, that's a fine vision. I mean, you know, in the last 2 years, you have always put the bar way too high for us.
To the next level.
Yeah, and now it's the time to go for the next level. I must say that, you know, we as a Nokians have thoroughly enjoyed the relationship and, you know, the strategic partnership we have had. The very unique thing I liked about this is the open dialogue, as you have said, right? And we have been honest to each other. We have been open to each other and we have called a spade a spade.
Okay, let me call you up on that one, since you call spade a spade. So what was your learnings in this journey, right? Obviously, we learned a lot from you guys, but what were your learnings, key takeaways in this last 24 months of amazing journey?
No, that's a fantastic question. And I must say that, you know, 2 years back when we started this journey and we were very, very vibrant, we are very, very excited about our cloud-native portfolio, and that was just coming to the bakings. And I still remember validating it on one cloud native platform, then going into the second chosen platforms, which is a hybrid environment of yours. And it's been a testing time for us. And because we were in the first part of iterations, second part of iterations, you were pushing the envelopes in three dimensions. You were pushing the envelopes on Cloud RAN, you were pushing the envelope on hybrid clouds, you wanted a fully automated lifecycle on the cloud native applications. And it was a fantastic journey. What we liked and what we realized over through as an industry, and I think not many people realize through this journey that hopefully together we have contributed more to the telco verticals here while we are moving ourselves in correcting both the workloads, the overall end-to-end ecosystem in the right direction of a very agile, open ecosystem. And that's what's more important. So a lot of learnings. As you said, it is just the chapter one of it. you know, and I think you laid out a fantastic view about automation and AI-driven automated network, both from bottom up and top down. And I think that calls for another whiteboard session between us.
Absolutely. But let me ask this question, right? So obviously we are doing something unique here. But where do you see all this coming together in a hyper-converged world? Because end of the day, we are in the connectivity business. We want to offer services to our customers. And as we think about like a metaverse coming through, there's a lot of buzz around that one. We know we are talking about self-driving cars. There's a lot of connectivity going around here. So how do you see this whole architecture, evolution of communication going?
No, that's yeah, you know, that's a good one. You put it out there because as you have heard me a few times now, it's about time we change the persona of the network to be more programmable in nature, right? And I think we agree on that. There was a whole lot of promise around 5G and now 5G advanced talks are being going on. And if one has to cross that bridge of what we call the B2B2X bridge, the network has to be open and need to participate in those distributed service chains, right? Well, I mean, we have talked about enough on the distributed service chains on the enterprise side of things. We have had enough examples of a cloud player, an application player, or a voice or a video or a communications player chaining together and providing a new service like Uber. How do we enable you to turn on all these verticals in a B2BX journey? And I think this is what we call the persona of what we call as network as code. And I think this is one piece absolutely both in the context of automation and both in the context of programmability is chapter 2 and 3 for us here. Mm-hmm. And you're right, I mean, we are ready on to take that journey.
Looks like we have taken an assignment for the next event to come up for this one. But hey, thank you, it was a pleasure.
It was always a pleasure. Thank you very much, Sid, for your time.
Thank you.